going on, everybody? It is April 28th. It is a Tuesday. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're staying safe. So I wanted to go over two articles. This one I'm just using as the setup because it feeds into the next article where they actually break down numbers. And I actually think that it's a really interesting look at things. It's no secret. Women dominate literature as far as people who buy it. A lot of men write books, but it's mostly women who buy them. You could say that they have the power to change the industry at will because they're the primary customers. A very low number of men read. I'm not sure what it is exactly. I don't know why that is. This article tries to answer that question, but you know they don't even know. This is more of an opinion piece. We don't know why men don't read. What we do know is that women do in mass. They pretty much control reading. If you really want to see something funny, next time you're in Walmart or Target or wherever, go to the book section and look at what kind of books are there. A lot of them are, you know, the dude with his shirt open holding some woman. You know what kind of books they are. They're like the hot, steamy romance books. Women eat that stuff up. They eat it up. That's why it's sold in mass. They pump those books out like crazy. Women control literature market. It's a fact. And apparently, now that's istophobic. Well, the contents of the books are istophobic, which I find interesting considering its words, right? You have to use your imagination to picture the characters in the books. But what I find funny here, like I said, is that women control the market, okay? If they didn't like things as they were, they could change it. Now, the biggest takeaway that I got from reading this is that you don't need to change things to bring women in, right? Like, what's the thing with comic books? Comic books are desperate to get that humongous female audience, right? And they've been changing things, making the dudes wimps and bringing all these powerful women in. And here's the interesting thing. When you look at the numbers they break down, and we're going to go over the stuff in this article, it seems that women prefer powerful, masculine men. So literally, the comics that you had before, like when you had Thor running around being buff and bearded and powerful, or Mr. Heroic Captain America and all that stuff, it seems like the women would be more into them, not gigantic, masculine She-Hulk. It's really strange, but you know, the problem with comics is you have all these woke, blue-haired people running around kind of controlling the industry. But that's not really the purpose of this video. So let's go through this a little bit here. It should come to no surprise to longtime readers as well as anyone remotely familiar with why feminism remains a necessity today that male-identifying writers and characters garner more positive reviews and descriptions than female. A new study by Super Summary, a company which provides strong guides for fiction and nonfiction, explored gender bias in their latest study, Strong Man, Beautiful Woman. So let's just go over the summary real quick for what they did. We don't need to read this verbatim here. They used the Bechdel test, which has three requirements. There's two female characters. They talk to each other and they don't talk about a man. And then they used 200 best-selling fiction books published between 1300 and 2015 using that test, which is kind of ridiculous. They also went over pronouns and gender and all of this stuff. That's pretty much it. So they say there is a gender bias in selling fiction, according to their research. This isn't surprising, of course, but the data here showcases it, and it's worth exploring. So they say there's 70% male authors, 29.6% are female authors. Now, here's the thing. This is what's funny, is they're going from 1300 to 2015. Honestly, you should probably go from a more modern age. I bet if you were to change, let's go and change that number and let's go from, 1970 or 1980 or 1990 to today. I bet you that this number is a little bit closer. It's almost like they purposely went back to the 1300s where everything was done by dudes. This is true. I'm not here to talk about history, but if you were to go a little bit more modern, this would be a little bit different. But they don't tell you that. So more men than women write books. Okay. Out of the 200 books. And they don't tell you the sample. I'd really like to break that down. But anyway, a protagonist breakdown. I got 9% men and women, 25% women, no gender assigned, and then 64% men. Now, the first thing that came to my mind when I saw this was, so you're telling me that women like male protagonists? You need to understand, the point here is that this is an industry driven by women. Women are already here. Books don't need to bring in more women. And I would imagine that every writer wants their books to bring in women. I would think that that would be a necessity, that you're literally thinking about that when you're writing a book because you want women to buy it. You want it to appeal to women because that's your market when it comes to books. When it comes to books. And it seems to me that women want male protagonists. So I just find it funny that, you know, all these other markets are trying, we got to let women see themselves in the role and all that. No wonder it's not working and not selling, because nobody wants it. Now, I'm not saying that there can't be female protagonists or any of that. There's 25% that are in here. But what I'm saying is, to me, in my opinion, from looking at all the stuff that's been broken down in this article, is that women want to see strong, masculine men in the role of the hero or whatever they're reading. The biggest thing that they're probably not, so they're going over to 200 popular books. That's why I say it would be nice to see what those books are, because, you know, I guarantee you the biggest seller of books are those romance, those steamy romance novels. Women want to see a big, strong hunk, you know, take a woman into his arms. It's just kind of thing. That's why those books sell. So I just found this really interesting. And they talk about the women are always married, men aren't married and stuff. It's like women want to see themselves, you know, with a big, strong guy married to them. I mean, I'm just going by what I've seen. So starting with gender in popular fiction, it's clear that the bulk of authors were male. The difference is pretty stark, too. Over 70% of best-selling books used in this study were by male authors, while only 30% were by women authors. This breakdown isn't too different in protagonist gender either. The bulk were male, roughly 65%, with female protagonists about 26%. The remaining percentage were books featuring both male and a female protagonist, or protagonists who had no stated gender. Male authors tend to write male characters far more than female, while female authors tend toward female characters. Though over a quarter of those best-selling books by women writers did feature male characters. It's hard not to see how the influence of growing up in a culture that worships the classics, typically books by white men, sets the standard for what a preferred character type is. Ingrained sexism is another likely explanation for why it is women are more comfortable writing male characters, while male writers who write female protagonists do so at a far lower percentage. What's more noteworthy, though, is that the books with male protagonists sold an average of 10 million more copies than those with female protagonists. Not all books by male authors failed the Bechdel test, but again, the Bechdel test is an extremely simple, straightforward measure of sexism in books. So, this is interesting. You're telling me, I'm just saying here, that an industry that's the majority of women are buying books with male protagonists, huh? That's interesting. You don't say. Now, like I said, if it was any other way, they would do it. If women were buying more strong, heroic women books, the entire industry of literature would shift to that. But that's not the case. And those books are there. I think they just don't seem that interested in them. You know, you could take a lot from this and apply it to movies and other mediums and make money too. I mean, if you really wanted to get the female audience, it's there. It's the same reason why Aquaman was successful for the DC universe. In that movie, they literally appealed that movie to soccer moms, putting Jason Momoa out there and having him, you know, look all hunky, his shirt off. They wanted him to look like that. They literally did a lot of marketing on the movie and say, hey, look at this big muscle-bound dude. You know, like that was part of the appeal. They did a whole marketing strategy. A lot of women went to go see that movie, which is a point that I really like to stress. I haven't stressed it in a long time. I did do a video on this when they were talking about that, and it worked. They did a lot of marketing on his relationship with his mother. They gave him a strong mother that he loved, and they had a big hunk guy in there. You know, a lot of messages of fertility in there, and powerful men. I'm just saying, it seems that that might be something that women like. And it's totally lost on the author of this article. No, that's not what women like. No, what women like, they don't know what they like. They don't know what they like. And then, of course, they also go on to slam pronouns, none of non-binary characters. Like, how stupid. I find this funny because this is a losing fight. You're not going to get the fight in here for women to want to change this. It's just an argument that's going to fall on deaf ears because you can't change the industry that's already dominated by women. So I really thought this was interesting. They go through here a lot of stuff. They talk about, like, so word associations. You got rich associated to a man. Oh, a man with money, huh? You don't say that a book like that might sell. Honest, given to man. Strong, given to a man. Beautiful, handsome, given associated to women. Beautiful woman. Wise, given to a man. Intelligent, given to a man. Perfect, given to a man. Kind, given to a woman. Weak, associated to men. That was what they call, like, whipping boys and stuff. Foolish, given to women. This is coming from their own study, from a market dominated by women. I found this pretty interesting. But of course, they want to change it. It's histophobic. Women don't know what they want, apparently. What you don't know what you want. Let us tell you what you want. So, interesting stuff. Let me know what you guys think, though, especially if women in the channel. I got like 12%, I think, female audience. If you're watching this, what do you think? What do you want to see in a book? Those comments I'd really like to read. In general, give me your thoughts on this, though. Also, make sure you're subscribed. Also, throw a like up if you would. Share the video. If you're new, subscribe as well. And hit that notification bell after you do that. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace. Also, if you want to help support the channel, check out my Teespring store. There's a link in the description. You can find some merchandise in there that you might want to check out. Also, take a moment. Make sure you're still subscribed to the channel. There's something going on right now, and they've been unsubscribing people. So just take a second and double check on that and subscribe if you're new.